Okay. My drink of the day. This is looks just like normal lemonade, but it's filled with vodka.
Seems to be a common theme here, doesn't it?
Really watered down lemonade with vodka.
So. Really strong vodka.
No, it tastes like water. You kind of go lemon, vodka, just, I guess.
Anything else you want to say about today?
Oh, today's been a busy day. Lots of things happened. We bought lots of interesting books, but...
Our porn collection of the day. I think we should have a closer look at these.
Mm. Let's have a look at today's porn collection. We went to a shop and bought some because we thought we should. Okay. So I'll bring it closer. We have Danny's one, which is called The Semen Junkie.
Hell yeah.
Which I think is pretty cool. And it's pretty much as you'd expect. She kind of has sex. Okay, now there's mine, which is completely different, and not in fact porn at all. I got a gore one, and I'll see if I find a good page for you. Okay, she's sucking something on her knee that seems to be alive. It's a face. Face on her knee. Someone cuts it off. It makes perfect... I bet if you read the story... Oh, is that the face? Is it alive? It makes perfect sense, I'm sure, if you actually read it. It seems relatively sensible, to be honest, apart from the old losing of limbs, and she's got a big stomach there for some reason. What else have we got? Oh, yeah, there we are. She's a bit worse for wear there, but she's not crying. She's not sad. So we bought that, and we just bought these things. And if you think these were bad, then there was some stuff in that shop that we kind of thought we should buy it because it's risque, but then we thought we shouldn't buy it because... yeah, great. We shouldn't buy it because it's just weird. Maybe we'll buy it later on in the week. Who knows?
Hey, this is... I was climbing Mount Fuji. We've been climbing for about 2 hours. Or maybe just a bit less than 2 hours. I think it was estimated at this point it should have taken us about 2.5 hours, so we're doing pretty well. I don't know if you can see my t-shirt, but it's so hot. It's as hot as it was in the city bits, but you're walking, so it's horribly sweaty. I've got just a little bit of normal coloured t-shirt at the bottom, and my knees, my sweaty knees, which is lovely. We did have a plan to start at the fifth station, which is like, I don't know, it's like an extra, it's quite close to the top, like 1,000 something from the top. But the bus to the base station took so long, and it cost like £7, or probably even more than that, just to get to there. We couldn't be asked to get the bus all the way to the top, or to the point where you're meant to walk from. So we're walking from the bottom of a mountain that's about 3 times the size of Snowdon, which is good. And on our way up, we found these. I don't know if you can see these big holes in the floor, followed by rocks, to take out any cyclists who think they can have a fun time riding down.
Well, we've been walking for about 3 hours now, and we finally reached the third station. Now, I don't know about you, but I think there's a high probability that we're going to get a lot of food and water here.
How are you feeling?
Much better. Food. Coke. This chair.
So where are we?
We are 2,230 metres up Mount Fuji.
Of you.
I was at the 8.5 station, maybe.
Not yet.
But I had quite an easy bit of walking. Nice trot, because we had a bit of traffic, but it's good. You can see down there, one of those strips is where we started from. One of the ones heading towards where we are now. See how far we've walked in a day. Well, we're 150 metres from the top.
About that.
It's tough. Ankles are buggered. I'm bleeding from the nose because of the altitude. Breathing's quite difficult. It's good. I'm going to do this. Probably maybe 12 hours, the whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Hello.
Hey.
And we have reached what we've decided is the summit of Mount Fuji. As you can see, it's pretty dark. I managed to lose my torch on the walk, which is really useful. The top of Mount Fuji, you've basically, it's an old volcano, so there's sort of a ring of little summits. However, there's a really deep drop in the middle, and because we've not got a torch, we're kind of stumbling around in the dark. We thought, look, we found a peak.
Yeah.
There's four peaks. There's only a couple of meters between each peak. So we're going to call this one Mount Fuji. Yeah. It's got a little shrine thing on
it.
Yeah,
it's quite nice.
So we think this is Mount Fuji. So we started our walk today at 10:30 from Fujiyoshita Station. And the time now is 8 p.m, which means we've been walking for 8.5 hours. Right?
No, 9.5. It's 8 now.
8 now, 10.5. No. Yes, no, 9.5. There we are. Brilliant with maths. So we've been walking for 9.5 hours from 800 metres to 370 odd metres in just one long slog. And we started out and there was basically no one with us.
It's not 370. 3,770.
3,770. Yeah. We walked down. We walked and there was no one with us because we started from the bottom. Then we got to the point, loads, hundreds of people. And then as it's got darker and we've got higher up, it's whittled away, and there's
some people sitting in a station just down there. There's about three of them.
Yeah, the station is just back there. There's no one else on top with us, and I was determined, even after losing the torch, to make it to the top in one day, and that's what we've done. Yeah. And I think it's been bloody good. What do you say, your sort of thoughts on Mount Fuji?
It's good. It's good. Expensive. Drinks, food. Mm. If you need to stay on the hotel in like one of the little shacky things, it's expensive, and the buses.
We'll give you a proper wash up in a bit on, you know, information that will be useful. But for now, we just want to get down without dying.
Yeah, we could just sleep down there on the benches.
I think it'd be too cold.
There's other people there.
Yeah.
See what they do.
Well, hopefully, hopefully we'll be alive and you'll get to see this. If not, then it's a video of why we died. Yeah. I forgot a torch. Well, I didn't forget it. I lost it. Probably because I took a penny from a shrine because I thought someone had dropped it, and then I realised I put it back, but the gods still felt the need to punish me. It's just evil. Anyway, see ya.
And take some water from there, because the ungodly man from the fifth station said he wouldn't give us any tap water. It did rain, so this isn't like really bad.